Oh, the chicken is so nice.
Yeah.
Hey, do you like some ketchup? It's so delicious.
Yes.
Want you try? It's nice.
Hey buddy, you can clear my plate.
You go high, I come.
Okay.
1, 2, hey guys, let's go. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Where are they?
Why are they taking so long?
Have they forgotten about me? Are they still playing? My friends hate me.
He's crazy. So stupid.
Okay, I'm sure it was all a misunderstanding. Please take a seat so we can begin our class. Okay, so here are our math multiplications exercise that we learned last week. I want you guys to start working on that, okay? Here you go. What's happening? Just get back to work, okay? What's so funny? Why can't you all get back to your work quietly?
Teacher, can I get a special? This one is wet.
No. You have interrupted my class one too many times already.
Hi, my name is Adam, and what you just saw were stories experienced by me, my friends, and other people in the autistic community.
When Adam was about 2 years old, we noticed that something was amiss when he stopped responding to his name being called. He became a little bit aloof, but it wasn't until like when he was about 3 that we finally got a diagnosis from HUCAM. And at that point in time, there were hardly any centers offering therapies. It wasn't until when he was about 4 years old that we found out about EAP, and since then we've started one-to-one home-based intensive therapy, and we haven't looked back since, and it's been about 15 years.
I'm really grateful for what EAP and my parents and everyone around me has done for me, and I couldn't be here without them. Learning is definitely hard for me, but I still try my best. I try to like study hard, get good results in sports and education and pretty much in life in general.
There were many challenges we faced when Adam started therapy. Getting the material was a real big problem for me because at that time there were hardly any early intervention programs that I had to make my own materials. And along the way, we needed to get Adam to play with peers, so I had to kind of request my friends' kids, and even some of my therapist's nephews and niece have come over to help us to be his peers. When Adam was about 5, we need to find a school, and he started in a small little kindergarten. Of course, being in school setup, Adam being different, there were many challenges as well. He's always been picked on.
When I came to school, this is where I knew I was different. I didn't feel comfortable acting the same way as most of my classmates do. You know, at first, during the time, I thought it was not a really big deal. However, they started to treat me different, more in a negative way. Probably make fun of me, bully me, maybe turn into actual like physical violence.
And the lucky thing is that the school allowed us to have shadow aides, and that really helped him progress through the years. And one year, I think when Adam was in year 4, he was so severely bullied that by the time he got to year 5, he was hardly speaking at all, even though he knew how to speak. And that's when he was given this teacher, Miss Candace. She worked with him through the year, and at the end of year 5, you will see a difference in Adam that was so remarkable because we really worked closely together. She really used a lot of motivation.
In primary and secondary, I started to make friends. This is where I haven't told them about anything about me yet. They would be friends with me, we would hang out all the time, and I would obviously still have my struggles in like academics, even talking to other people who I may not know really well. So I would work hard and I somehow managed to overcome it.
Something really remarkable happened when Adam was in school. When he was about 10 years old, he was noticed to have talent for swimming in school by the PE teacher. But then it was really surprising because Adam used to be really fearful of water. You remember?
I remember that.
When I used to take him to the pool just to have the little tippy toe in the water, he would just cry and scream and make a real big scene. It was embarrassing, but I kept taking him to the water just to get the little tippy toe. And the next few weeks, it would be up until his knees, body, and then late. Finally getting him to dunk in his head, and it was really like many, many years of trying to get him to really be comfortable in the water. And then when I was told when he was 10 by the school PE teacher that he was really, really good at swimming, so that's when I started giving him a little bit of swimming training, more of a competitive swimming training, and he was selected for a Selangor swim team about around the age of 12.
You know, swimming does help me physically and mentally as well, because I think this is something I'm good at. I finally have a talent. I've developed more social skills. I apply that to like school and also when talking to family.
I think swimming gave him a really boost of confidence. And this is something that Adam can say, I did it, I own it. This is something I've done it on my own.
If you see someone being bullied or mistreated unfairly, try and step in, whether it be talking to a parent or calling someone, because you can save them. To anybody who has been bullied before, I'm sorry, but at the same time, you're not an embarrassment, you're a survivor, and we need you in this world. to any of the people that still continue to bully, put yourself in the other person's shoes. You could have a toll on their mental health and to the point of even suicide. We may act different. We may think different. We may overall be different people. But at the end of the day, we are still human beings. We are still individual people. And we deserve to be treated with respect and dignity. We are here to raise awareness about autism and to stop bullying today.